Welcome to Naresh Technologies. I'm Bangaraju, and in this video, I will demonstrate about properties. What are these properties? Property is a member of class using which we can expose values associated with a class to the outside environment. So it is going to be a member, and this particular member of the class is used for exposing values associated with a class to the outside environment. What I mean to tell is, see, I have a class here called as a circle class, and in this class I am going to declare a variable called as radius, double radius. So what is the value? 12.34. okay, now the class is public. Because the class is public, we can create the instance of this class wherever you want, means within the project, out of the project, anywhere. Public means no rules. So watch this. Now I have taken another class here. What is the class? Test circle. In this test circle, what I am going to do is, I am just going to define a main method, and now here I will create the instance of the circle class. Circle C is equals to new circle. So created instance of the circle class, and once after creating the instance of the circle class, using that C, can I access the radius? No, you cannot. Why you cannot? Because in the class, the variable is declared as a private. Because the default scope for the members of a class is private, the variable radius is private, the field radius is a private. So because it is private, you cannot access that radius from here. You can create an instance. When you create an instance internally, memory also will be allocated for the radius, but the radius cannot be accessed outside of the class. Okay, now you understand. The class circle, this represents a entity. What is the entity? Circle is the entity, and this entity has an attribute called as radius. Okay, and this particular radius is private. Because it is private, out of the class no one can access radius. See, when I create the instance here, what will happen? You know, memory will be allocated, and under that will store you the value of radius. Now what is the radius value? 12.34. So this is the radius value. The value will be stored for you inside the memory. Name of the attribute, radius. Radius is the attribute, and the memory is allocated for this. So when the instance is created here, okay, so this is the instance. See, let's assume this is our instance, and for this, this is the memory allocated, and under this we have the radius. Everything will be common, but using C we cannot access the radius. Why we cannot access? Because it is a private member. For private members, memory will be allocated, that will be done for sure, but you cannot access them outside of the class. So I want to access it now. If you want to access it now, the first way how you can access is by using a concept called as public variables. So declare this variable as public, public double radius. Once you declare public double radius, now can I access it? Means yes. Why? Public, global, can be accessed from anywhere. Can I access this? Means yes, you can access it now. So now you notice it, you can access the radius from the test circle class. See, I'm declaring a variable, double radius is equals to C dot radius. Double radius is equals to C dot radius. You are accessing the value. What are you doing? We are getting the value. We are getting the value. And now, if I want to modify the value, I can modify the value also. That is also possible. C dot, because the variable is public, you can even modify the value. Radius is equals to 56.78. I can modify the value. So what am I doing now? Setting a new value. Here getting the old value, and here setting a new value. Like this, we are getting the value as well as we are setting a value also. Both we are able to do in this place. Okay, so once the variable is declared as public, anyone can get the value, anyone can set the value. Okay, variable is a general terminology, but actually speaking, we should speak it as a field. It is called as a field. So this field is declared as public, so anyone can get the value as anyone can set the value. So here starts the problem. What is the problem? The problem is, I don't have any control on the value now. What is that? I don't have any control. Once the variable is declared as a public, anyone can get that value and anyone can set that value. So no one can control it. Means suppose I want to give only get access to the value. I want to give only get access to the value outside the class. Outside the class, I don't want anyone to modify the value. Means I want to give a permission for you to watch the value, but I don't want to give a permission to modify the value. But not possible. Why? Once you declared it public, anyone can get, anyone can set. Okay. In some situations, I want to give only set permission, not get permission. Means you can only set the value, but I don't want to show my value. You tell your value, I'll take it, but I'm not going to expose my value. Not possible. Same problem. You cannot restrict it at all. Once it is public, anyone can get, anyone can set. So now the point is how to restrict this now. How to restrict this? If you want to restrict this, the first important thing is never declare the variable as public. Never declare the variable or field as public. A very important point to remember. But you know, when you are developing applications tomorrow in the real-time environment, so remember this point. Never declare fields of a class as public. If you declare them as public, you will lose hold on the value. Anyone can get that value, anyone can set that value. So that's not a good idea at all. So what to do is, better declare the variable as private. Earlier it was private only. Make it private. So remove public here. Once you remove public, no one can access this value. This is not possible. This is not possible now. So you cannot access the value. So but I want to provide access to the value. I want to provide access to the value. If that is the case, what we can do, you know, we can do it with the help of methods. We can do it with the help of methods. Like what? Public double get radius. In this method, I am writing the logic as return radius. Yeah, whenever you call the method, it will return the radius value now. So can I call the method here? Double radius is equals to, double radius is equals to C dot get radius. You understand now what is the advantage? What is the advantage, you know? By calling this method, you can only get the value. You can only get the value, but you cannot set the value. Why? Because the variable is private, it is not accessible to you. You are getting the value through the method, and this method is going to give you only get access, provides only get access to the value. Suppose you want to provide only set access now. You want to provide set access. If you want to provide set access, you can define a method now. Public void set radius double value. What is the code? The code is radius is equals to value. Means you're taking this value and assigning to the variable radius. So now, can I modify the value? Yes. How? C dot set radius 56.78. I'm assigning a value. So by using this, I'm getting the value. By using this, I'm setting the value. So this provides only get access to the value, and this provides only set access to the value. Like this, we can do it with the help of the two methods. You may have a doubt here. What is the doubt? You're defining two methods and you're giving get and set access. What is the point of writing the two methods? Without that, if you declare public only, you can give get set access now. Again, why to write the methods and provide the access? The thing is very simple. Don't write this method. If you don't write this method, you understand you are giving only get access to the value. Or don't write this method. You are giving only set access to the value. Only set access to the value. Get access is not there, only set access. If both are defined, you are giving both get and set access. If you understand this correctly, there are three options in providing the value. One, only get access. Two, only set access. 3 both get and set access. But public variable, if you take into consideration, public variable will give you only get set access. Only get set. I cannot give only get access, or I cannot give only set access, but now possible with the help of the methods. So we are able to safeguard the value here. Means we are giving security for the appropriate value. Means we can control everything and say, I will give you only get access, or I will give you only set access, like this. So this is how we can define the methods and provide access to the value. But understand here, we have two methods here, I deleted, and with the help of the two methods, we are providing access to the value. One method for getting and one method for setting. Okay, if only first method is defined, it is get access but no set access. If only second method is defined, it is only set access but not get access. If both are defined, both get and set access. Now, actually our discussion is not about methods, our discussion is properties. Okay, now understand, property. A property is basically a combination of the two methods. How do you define? Watch. Modifiers, type, name, get statements. We call this as a get accessor, set some statements. We call it as a set access. So like this, we are just going to have two different blocks of code now. What is this? Simple here. This get accessor is similar to the get method we defined here. This set accessor is similar to the set method we defined here. Means both these two we are going to combine together into one block of code. You may ask a doubt, what is the advantage? The advantage is two advantages. First, here if you understand, the names are different. Here we are calling get radius and here we are calling set radius. But here we will not have two names here, only one name. That only for getting, that only for setting. Second advantage, here we are declaring a parameter for accessing the value. Means when the client wants to assign a value, he will assign value to the parameter and you will get this. Okay. But when you come to the property, you don't require to declare this variable at all. No need. You don't require to declare. Means the code what you written in the get accessor and the code what you written in the set accessor, both these things, two things we can combine and write it under one single block here. And that is what we call as a property. Understand? How do you define? Modifier. I'm writing public. Okay, type. What type of value is it? The type of value is double. Radius is double. So double. Name, you give a name called as some name, radius. Okay, we are giving a name called as radius. Okay, or otherwise radius property, some name like this. And now in this we need to write two different blocks. One is get and the second one is set. Okay, how do you write it? Watch. Get, this is the code. Simple, will write on the same line, no issues, to simplify the logic. Okay, so now the code what you written in the get radius is return radius, the same thing what I get written here under get. Second, set. What you write in the set, what code you written in the set radius method, now copy paste here, copy this and use it. So this is what we call as a property. If you understand, you did not write anything new here. Both these two things are combined together into one particular block of code and we call it as a property. The advantage here is, it is get radius, set radius, two names, but here only one name, that is radius property. Okay, second advantage. Here we declared a parameter called as a double value, but here we don't require anything called as a double value. Then how it is implicitly declared? It is implicitly declared. The name is value only. You cannot change the value only. And which type? This type will be same as your property type. What is the property type? Double. So this value also will be double only. You understand here? Double value. Here value enough. So double value. Automatically that is going to be declared as a double value. So that is how you define a property, means you are combining two methods together and making it in a simple form called as a property. Okay, again, same advantage. What is it? If you write only get accessor, if you write only get accessor, your property will give you only get access, means it is a read only property. If you write only set, then your property will give you only set access, means it is a read write property. Okay, delete this. Property is read only. Delete this. Property is write only. Provide both. Property is read write. So what advantage is specified with these two, you have the same advantage with this also. Remember both the two names, and no need to go for declaring the value parameter again. So straight away you can write it. That's all. The get accessor represents a value returning method without any parameter. Understand? It is a value returning method without any parameter. So get accessor, what I'm telling you, represents a value returning method without parameter. It represents a value returning method without parameter. Okay, now talking about the set accessor, what about the set accessor? The set accessor represents your set method. What's it? Non-value returning method with parameter. It is a non-value returning method with parameter. Represents a non-value returning method with parameter. What is the parameter? Value. And that is implicitly declared. That is what a property. Now let me copy this. Come back to your class now. Which class? The circle class, and then paste it here. So if you notice, which one is simple now, writing two separate methods or writing a property? This looks a little bit simple when compared with this. Okay, so now it is ready. Now anyone can access this radius with the help of the radius property. Watch it. Double radius is equals to C dot radius property. And remember, property will not have braces. So anyone will think like it is a field only. They'll think it is a variable or a field only. No one will understand this is property. So when you are assigning a value, how to assign a value? Not like this. C dot radius property is equals to 56.7. Just like a field you are using, have you noticed it? It's a public field. How do you get and how do you set? Now you are doing in the same way. So now all these things are not required. All these things are not required now. So this is how you're going to define a property. Now you understand the definition of it. Property is a member of a class using which we can expose values associated with a class to the outside environment. See, it is a member. And this is exposing the values associated with a class to the outside environment. So this is the radius, and this is a value associated with a class, and we are exposing the value through the property radius, and the property name is called radius property. Basically, if you call radius property, someone may understand again the property. So the better name will be radius only, not as radius property. The better name will be radius only, not as a radius property. So if I give radius, if I give the name as radius, a naming collision arises now. Why? The variable or the field name is radius already, property name radius. Two members cannot have the same name. What to do? See, generally, tomorrow you define a class now, and the class contains some 100 fields in it. If the class contains 100 fields in it, it is not must that you require to define a property on every field. Why? 100 fields are there, but I want to expose only 10 fields outside. I have 100 fields, but how many I want to expose them? 10 only. If I want to expose only 10, it is not necessary to define 100 properties now. How many properties we are going to define? 10 only. We define only 10 properties, not as 100 properties. So listen, I have a class here, some thousands of lines of code is here. Now on the top, I declared some 100 variables. Afterwards, some constructors, some methods. In the bottom, some properties. Like this I define. But all these 100, only 10 only we have properties. 100 properties are not there, only 10. How do we know which field has a property, which field doesn't have a property. Means I defined of all the code given to you. Tomorrow you are looking into my code. When you look into my code, how do you remember on what fields properties are present and what fields properties are not present? What you required to do, you need to scroll up and down now, come to the bottom, check out, go up, check out, like this, a big nonsense. So to overcome this particular problem, we follow a pattern or a convention. What is that, you know? If at all you wanted to define a property on any variable, make a habit of declaring that variable prefixing with the underscore. There's a general convention what we follow throughout the industry. What you do, declare the variable prefixing with the underscore, underscore radius. So what is the advantage? The advantage is, now here what you write, return underscore radius. Here what you write, underscore radius is equals to value. This is how you are going to write. Now see, property name can be radius now. Why? Field name is not radius. Field name is underscore radius. Property name is radius. Okay, like this, you can define different names for different things here. Property will have the name radius. Variable will have the name underscore radius. You may have another doubt. Why same name? Why same name means generally the best name means the apt name for this particular property will be radius only. If you give some other name, again it will be confusion. The apt name will be radius only. Okay. And at the same way, the best apt name for the variable also will be radius only. If I declare it as R in 100 variables, if a name is declared R, what is R? How do you? So name radius only will be apt. So both of them should have the same name. But you cannot declare two members with the same name. That is why here I am using underscore and here I am not using the underscore. Okay, so this is how you define the properties under your class now. Fine. Now, what is the advantage of defining the properties? Already one advantage I said you. What is this? You can give restricted access to the value. Means only get access or only set access or both get set access. Second advantage is conditional access, conditional assignment. What is that conditional access, conditional assignment? What is the conditional access, conditional assignment is? Right now, the value of the radius is 12.34. I want to change it. So here I can change this. I can change the value. I'm changing. The value we are going to set, the new value we are going to set for the radius should be greater than the old radius. Should be greater than the old radius. If it is not greater, the assignment should not be successful. Okay, how do you restrict this? Watch it. Now the property name is not radius property. What is it? Just radius. Here, I am assigning a value, this should not be accepted. Why should not be accepted? Because it is less than the original radius. The value should be greater than the original radius. But today when I assign this like this, the value will directly be assigned to the radius and the value will be overridden here. The value 12.34 will be changed to 12.33, but it should not happen. It should not happen. If that is the case, we can write some conditions in the code. So this is our set accessor and you are writing underscore radius is equals to value. But the point you understand, what you want the value to be greater than the existing radius. Less than the existing radius should not be assigned. Means a new value should be greater than the old value. So I want to write a condition. What is the condition? If value means user assigned, greater than, it should be greater than, should not be equal also, greater than the old value. What is the old value? Underscore radius, then only this statement should execute. Then only this statement should be executed. So now, if you understand now, you are assigning 12.33. The value 12.33 comes to value. Is it greater than radius? No. Why? What is the value? 12.34. It is not greater. So what happens? You know, this statement won't execute. So what will happen? Value will not change. The value will not change. Why are you putting a condition like this? I think you are giving an example, that's all. Tomorrow, you are developing a banking application. There is a balance. Okay? You want to withdraw some money. And the money you are going to withdraw should be less than the balance in your account. You have 5,000 in your account. Can we withdraw 10,000 now? No. If you have 5,000 means you can withdraw 5,000 only. If at all the bank has any minimum balance rule of 500 rupees, we need to leave that 500 and withdraw 4,500. So conditions are required. If you don't write the conditions, problem starts now. You need to write a condition. So because you are able to write a condition, because it is a block of code, you can write a condition like this. Okay, so what is this? If the condition satisfies only, the assignment will be succeeded. Condition doesn't satisfy, assignment will not succeed. If assignment doesn't succeed, there will be old value inside now. The old value, what is the old value? 12.34. That value will not change. The old value will be present as it is in the code. Okay, but not the new value. If condition satisfies, new value will come. If condition doesn't satisfy, old value will be persisting for you at that place. So that's the advantage here. Okay, someone send me a question like this. What is it? Property you are defining, well and good. You are able to restrict the things, but you are given both get and set access. You are given both get and set access, means anyone can get, anyone can set. This can be done with a public variable also. If you simply declare this variable as public, anyone can get, anyone can set. You may have a doubt in the future. What's it? You are telling property and you have written a get block, you have written a set block. If you write only read only property, okay, only get access. If you write only write only property, okay, only set access. But if the read write property, both get and set access will come now. Why to write that? You can go with a public variable. Public variable also gives you read write access. The answer for that is what I am showing you right now here. You delete the property, you delete the whole property once. Let me delete the whole property once. Now the variable is public. Anyone can get, anyone can set. But what about the condition now? What about the condition? What condition? The new value being assigned should not be less than the old value. Where should I write the condition? I cannot write any condition. Why? Because when we assign a value to a variable, any block of code will not execute. So there is no place for writing the conditions there. So compulsory value will be assigned off. So cannot be restricted. But understand the advantage of the property. Whenever you are assigning a value to a property, a block of code will execute. Which block? Set block. Because the set block is executing, in the set block I can write all the conditions to restrict it and do it. Tomorrow you want to write a condition in the get, you can write a condition in get also. When will get to execute? See what are you doing here? Getting the value means calling the get accessor. Setting the value, calling the set accessor. See? Calling the get accessor of property, calling the set accessor of property. You are calling the get accessor of the property and you are calling the set accessor of the property like this. Like this, you are just calling the appropriate accessors in both these two cases. So that's what happens here. So when you just try this, you are calling the get accessor, means at this time this block of code will execute. Any conditions you can put there. You are calling the set accessor, at this time this block of code executes. Any condition you can put there. But in case of public variable you can do this. That is the advantage with a property when compared with a public variable. Okay, so this is what a property is. So if you follow clearly, property is a member of class using which we can expose values associated with a class to the outside environment. So every class will be associated with some properties, and with the help of those properties we can start accessing the values. Okay, thank you for watching the video. For more videos, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, Naresh IT.